Hey everybody, this is Pat Foster with Swap Moto Live. We're out at Glen Helen today. It's rough, it's gnarly. We're testing some suspension on the YZ450. So if you watch our shootouts, you know that the YZ450 pretty unanimously has the best suspension in the class. And frankly, I've been riding the Yamaha the last 3 or 4 years. I've never done the suspension. It works that good. But you know, we say it all the time in our shootouts. Hey, listen, you get a bike, you set it up for yourself. You're probably gonna do the suspension. You're probably gonna bolt on a few things. We thought, what the heck, let's give this a try. So we sent the suspension to Ross at Enzo. Ross is the man, been doing this over 40 years. He's doing the Star Racing Yamaha 450s. They're killing it outdoors. We thought, who better to do it than Ross himself. So, frankly, I didn't have any complaints about the Yamaha. We sent him the suspension and he goes, hey Pat, what do you want it to do? And I go, I don't know. He goes, well, what do you not like? And I go, I don't know. It works really good. But I've got to imagine that there's something we could do better, right? It's not set up for a 190-pound guy. I'm racing Mammoth next week. It's gonna be rough, it's gonna be gnarly. Hey man, I want my wheels to stay on the ground, I wanna be tracking, I wanna be clawing for traction. Do your thing. You know, kind of the unicorn is, hey, I want it plush up on top, I want good bottoming control. If you could do those things for me, that'd be amazing. So fortunately, he knew exactly what to do. Starting with the forks, Yamaha runs a softer front fork spring, And it kind of carries a little bit more weight on the front end. Yamaha's not known as being the best cornering bike, so they put a little softer spring in the front, put a little more weight up front to get it to carve a little better. Well, when it's fast and choppy and rough, that's not the best recipe for stability. So they actually went up one spring rate on the fork, pulled the fork up a little higher, balanced the bike out, which, number one, that feels great. Two, the unicorn that I was talking about, plush up on top, good bottoming resistance. Enzo has their own spring tube, the aluminum, good hold up at the beginning, great bottoming control at the bottom. Ross built it himself for exactly what I was looking for. On the track, translated into excellent handling. Like I said, Glen Helen today is really choppy. This bike stays really well connected on the little chop, but man, great bottoming resistance. In fact, I thought I had it set up pretty good where it was really soft up top and comfortable. I come in and I hadn't even bottomed the fork out. So I'm gonna play a little bit more with it, chase a little bit more softness up on top, because I still have room to play with. The rear shock, kind of interesting. A lot of folks go with a bigger bladder, more capacity in the bladder. Enzo actually found out that the Yamaha reacts better to a smaller bladder. So they put a smaller bladder system in. They've got their own proprietary compression adjuster. And you know what? Like I said, there was no complaints with the rear end on the Yamaha before, but it just feels like the bike stays better connected to the track. It absorbs the hits better. It gets more substantial quickly, right? So it's a little bit less movement, which is something that I really like. I don't want my bike to move around a lot. I don't want a lot of wallow. This bike is really deliberate. Like I said, very substantial, and it's confidence inspiring. One of the things that makes me really nervous is hard bottoms, right? When you're going through the stroke, that's when the bike reacts and kicks. I'm not getting any of that. It's just a very controlled feel, and man, I just came coming away really impressed with this bike. The overall balance is better. Straight line stability is great. Still corners, it hasn't hampered the cornering at all. Still feels good as my stock bike, but just a lot more confident in the suspension. Really pumped. If you guys are looking for a little something more out of your Yamaha, do what Ferrandis does, send it to Enzo. They're killing it. Thank you guys.